This is Mark Watney. He's an astronaut who's been living on Mars for just over a year, an Earth year. Watney didn't intend to stay on Mars for that long. He was part of the Ares-3 mission, which was hit by a violent storm soon after landing. The rest of the crew evacuated and Watney was left behind. This is the story of The Martian, a film based on Andy Weir's 2011 novel. The novel and the film are pretty scientifically accurate. Living on the red planet isn't easy, and Watney does an amazing job of surviving on Mars, despite the odds.
The atmosphere on Mars is 95% carbon dioxide and is about 80 times thinner than the atmosphere on Earth. That's about as good as a vacuum to your vitals. If you are exposed to Mars's atmosphere, your tears, your saliva, the moisture in your skin, and the water in the alveoli of your lungs would all boil away.
Spot on, physics girl. So Watney lives in a pressurized environment with an oxygenator and an atmospheric regulator. But even with this equipment, there's still a lot of weird things that can happen to you if you live on Mars, or elsewhere in space. During the Apollo 11 mission in 1969, Buzz Aldrin reported seeing strange flashes of light. Later experiments found the high-energy charged particles that make up cosmic rays were causing astronauts, just like Buzz, to perceive these flashes.
Cosmic rays are a form of radiation, typically very high energy and often composed of just protons. Some originate from our sun and some from outside the solar system, possibly from the supernova of massive stars.
These light flashes perceived by astronauts are called cosmic ray visual phenomena. The thing is, the light flashes aren't real. You can't see cosmic rays. The cosmic rays pass through the astronauts' eyes, mess with their optic nerve, and make them think they are seeing flashes of light. And studies have found that astronauts often have poorer vision after space flight. Increased pressure and fluid shifts in their heads can cause structural changes in the eye. On Earth, our magnetic field protects us against radiation from cosmic rays. It protects astronauts on the International Space Station too. They're only about 400 kilometers away. But on further missions, like ones to Mars, cosmic rays mess with more than your vision. In one study, researchers exposed mice to small doses of the kind of radiation people would experience on a 9-month trip to Mars.
You know, cosmic rays, typically very high energy and often composed of protons.
After 6 weeks, the researchers noticed changes in the structure of the mice's brain cells. They had fewer dendrites, the little branches that carry electrical pulses of information from cell to cell. The mice became confused more easily and were less likely to explore. The researchers suggested if this happened in astronauts, it could impair their ability to problem solve. Tests have also shown astronauts can lose 1% of their bone density per month in space, compared with the 1% we lose per year on Earth. They have disturbances in their sleep, balance, and blood pressure, which all adds up to be pretty stressful. Astronauts are incredibly brave, and despite all this, they go into space all the time, and many live very long lives. But we've only been as far away as the moon. What would happen if people traveled to, say, Mars? There's lots of interest in going, from NASA's Orion spacecraft to SpaceX's Mars Colonial Transporter. But remember that Mark Watney, unfortunately, is a fictional character. We haven't been there yet, and we don't know what it might do to our brains, psychologically or physiologically.
According to NASA, a manned mission to Mars could take 9 months to get there and 9 months to get back. And then the astronauts would have to stay on Mars for 3 months, waiting for Mars and Earth to realign for the return trip. So we're looking at a 21-month journey.
We have started preparing for a manned Mars mission. Mars 500 was an isolation experiment that ran for 520 days in a pressurized facility in Russia. From 2007 to 2011, three crews lived and worked in a mock spacecraft. Mars 500 was the longest simulated space mission ever. As missions increase in distance and duration, there's a constant dependence on automated life support systems, a higher degree of isolation and confinement, and the lack of short-term rescue possibilities in case of emergencies. The astronauts on this mission did a lot of psychological evaluations before the mission, during and after. The European Space Agency described the most useful personality traits for an astronaut as tolerance, sympathy, balance in time spent in a group and alone, and a sense of humour. And these traits are some that NASA look for in astronaut selection. NASA psychologists add that good astronaut candidates are easygoing, have good social skills, and are also very resilient. Going back to the Martian, we can see these traits in Mark Watney. His resilience, easygoing nature, and sense of humour all contribute to his story. And we can see these traits in astronauts in real-life space dramas.
Like when Apollo 13's oxygen tank exploded, or when astronauts had to fix Hubble's faulty mirror. There's some exhilarating science in these space rescues.
Follow me over to Physics Girl, where Diana explores the most epic space rescues in history.
And emotions were surely tense in this next rescue.
The date is 1985. Cosmonaut Vladimir Denisov and his crew are tasked with a very unusual mission: to enter a dead space station.
And subscribe to BrainCraft for a new brainy video every week.